Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Dear students, today we'll start an important chapter from the organic chemistry. In the 11th class, there are two unit chapters in the organic chemistry. The first very chapter, that is some basic concept in organic chemistry, and the second chapter, that is hydrocarbons. These are the two important chapters as far as the 11th class are considered, because the 12th organic chemistry, there are 28 marks in the organic chemistry of 12th class, and all the 20 marks, they are based on these two chapters. That is, this chapter number first is some basic concepts in the organic chemistry, the second is the hydrocarbons. In this very chapter, in this very lecture, we will start with the first chapter, that is some basic concepts in the organic chemistry. Dear students, first we will try to define how we can define the organic chemistry. Simply, you have to remember, it is the branch of the chemistry which deals with the study of organic. This is the definition of organic chemistry. Classical definition, the first definition you have to remember, it is the branch of the chemistry which deals with the study of organic compounds. Now, before starting this very chapter, first you should know what is meant by organic compounds. First, we will try to define the organic compounds. Dear students, as far as organic compounds are considered, there are two definitions. There are two definitions by which we can understand the organic compounds. The first very definition, that is classical definition. Classical definition. Classical definition, the first very definition, that is classical definition. Dear students, as per the classical definition, how we can define the organic compounds? As per this definition, organic compounds can be defined as those compounds which were originally obtained. This is the definition, classical definition, which were originally isolated. But here you have to remember, isolation can be directly, or it can be indirectly. This is the point you have to mention here. Isolation, it can be direct or it can be indirect. The compounds which were originally obtained from living matter. From living matter. Dear students, living matter, here it means plants and animals. Plants and animals. It means that those compounds which are obtained from plants and animals, those compounds were named as organic compounds. For example, if you take some examples, for example, if you have the fat. Fat is obtained from the animal. It means that it has the living origin. It is the organic in nature. For example, we have the oils. For example, we have the proteins. For example, we have the carbohydrates. Carbohydrates. For example, we have the urea. Urea, where from the urea is obtained, dear students? Urea is obtained from urine of mammals. It means that urea has the organic nature, it has the living nature, hence it is the organic compound. Remember this point. It is the classical definition of organic. These compounds which were originally obtained from the living sources, plants and animals, those compounds were named as organic compounds. But dear students, we have an alternate definition. We have another important definition of organic compounds. And what is that very definition? That is modern definition. Modern definition, the definition which we are using nowadays, that is modern definition of organic compounds. Dear students, first we have to remember, when we go for qualitative analysis of organic compounds, Dear students, first you should know what is meant by qualitative analysis. To understand this definition, first you should know the qualitative analysis. For example, if you have the methane, if I will tell you go through the qualitative analysis means which elements are present in the methane. And it is clear from the molecular formula, it contains carbon and it contains hydrogen. This is qualitative analysis. And the second analysis, that is quantitative analysis. Quantitative analysis means if you have the carbon, what is the number of carbon atoms? Quantitative, what is the number of carbon atoms? If you have the hydrogen, what is the number of carbon hydrogen atoms? When we mention number, that is quantitative analysis. But here I will mention simply qualitative analysis. Dear students, when we have gone through the qualitative analysis of organic compounds, it has been found that organic compounds, they contain the element carbon. Remember this point. After the qualitative analysis, it has been found that organic compounds contains the element carbon. You have to mention here, dear students, it directly means, as per the modern definition, you can remember organic compounds are the carbon compounds. These are the compounds which contains the element carbon. It means that carbon compounds are the organic compounds. This is the modern definition of organic compounds. You have to simply remember carbon compounds are the organic compounds. Besides carbon, when you have gone through the qualitative analysis in the lab, besides the carbon, it has been found that they usually contain another element, that is hydrogen. It means that carbon is essential. Carbon compounds are the organic compounds, but besides the carbon, another element has been usually found in the organic compounds, that is the hydrogen. And in the 10th class, in the previous classes, you know that those compounds which contains carbon and hydrogen only, those are known as hydrocarbons. Hence, I will try to define here hydrocarbons, two important points of hydrocarbons. Now, how you can define the hydrocarbons? These are the simple organic compounds. These are the organic compounds, hydrocarbons. These are the class, it is the class of organic compounds. But you have to here mention, these are the organic compounds. Here you have to mention three points. They contain, first point, carbon and hydrogen only. Hydrogen only. This is the first point regarding the hydrocarbons. These are the organic compounds which contains carbon and hydrogen only. This is the first point. It means that compounds containing carbon and hydrogen only, those are known as hydrocarbons, and they are organic in nature. The second point you have to mention, these are the simplest organic compounds. You have to mention this. Hydrocarbons are the simplest organic compounds. Simplest organic compounds. This is the second point, simplest organic compound. The first, they contain carbon and hydrogen only. The second, they are the simplest organic compounds. And the third point you have to mention, they are the parents. This is the very important point. Parents of all organic compounds. Parents of all organic compounds. What is meant by parents of all organic? This is the point you have to mention, you have to remember. What is meant by parents of all organic compounds? It means that all organic compounds can be derived from the hydrocarbons. All the organic compounds, any organic compound in the organic chemistry, that can be derived from the hydrocarbon. Hence, these are the parents of all organic compounds. I will take two or three examples here to understand what is meant by parents of all organic compounds. Dear students, for example, if you have the simplest organic compound, that is methane. Methane is the simplest organic compound. Simplest hydrocarbon, that is the methane. Dear students, If you replace one hydrogen and I will introduce chlorine atom, what you will get? You will get an organic compound because it contains the carbon. You will have CH3Cl. This is the parent and it is known as methane. This is parent. And from this parent we have derived an organic compound. This is chloromethane. This is chloromethane, and chloromethane, it is the derivative. It is the derivative, or you can say it has been derived from the parent, from this hydrocarbon. Remember this point. This is the parent hydrocarbon and it is the derivative of the hydrocarbon. Remember this point. If you replace two hydrogen atoms, you can introduce two chlorine atoms. It means that if you replace one, you have to introduce one atomic group. If you replace two, you have to introduce two or three atomic group. What is meant by atomic group? Here chlorine, it is atom. You can also introduce OH. OH is group. Remember this point. You can introduce NO2. NO2 is group. It means that if you replace one hydrogen, you have to replace one atom or one group. If you replace two hydrogen, you have to introduce two atomic group. Number must be same. Here what you will have? You will have CH2Cl2. What will be the name? It is dichloromethane. Dear students, it is dichloromethane. It means that here you have to remember simple, you have to remember this very important point. You have the hydrocarbon, it is the parent, and from the parent you can derive large number of organic compounds, and these derived organic compounds, these are known as derivatives. In nutshell, you have to remember hydrocarbons and their derivatives are organic compounds. Hydrocarbons and their derivatives are organic compounds. And that branch of chemistry which deals with the study of hydrocarbons and their derivatives, that branch of chemistry is known as organic chemistry. It means that you have to remember this very important definition. This is the modern definition of organic chemistry. Modern definition of organic chemistry. How you can define the modern as per this definition? You have to remember it is the branch of the chemistry. It is the branch of the chemistry, branch of the chemistry which deals with the study of hydrocarbons. These are the parents, you have to remember it, and their derivatives. This is the first point which you have to remember in this very lecture number first. How you can define the organic chemistry? It is the branch of the chemistry which deals with the study of hydrocarbons and their derivatives. And as far as the hydrocarbons are considered, you have to remember three points. These are the compounds, organic compounds which contains carbon and hydrogen only. The second, these are simplest organic compounds. And the third, these are the parents of all organic compounds. Dear students, the first very topic in this very chapter, that is very important topic, that is classification. This is the first very important topic, that is classification of organic compounds. Classification of organic compounds. This is the first very important topic which you have to remember, classification of organic compounds. Dear students, as far as the number of organic compounds is very large in the organic chemistry. We have a large number of organic compounds. It is not possible for we people, for the organic chemists, to study the compounds individually. We cannot study one by one all organic compounds. Hence, organic chemists have classified the organic compounds into two categories. And what is the aim of this classification? In order to simplify, in order to systemize the study of organic compounds, all the organic compounds have been classified into two categories. Just like you have learned that classification of elements. in the classification of elements in the periodic table, they have been classified in groups. Why? In order to simplify the study of elements. In the same way, to make the study of organic compounds simpler, organic compounds have been broadly classified into two categories. The first one, you have to remember, that is acyclic, or you can say open chain compounds. This is the first class of organic compounds, that is acyclic or open chain. The second class, which you have to remember, that is cyclic. We have cyclic, or you can say closed chain organic compounds. Closed chain organic compounds. This is the first topic. You have to mention classification of organic compounds. You have to remember two classes, acyclic, and we have the cyclic, or you can say closed chain compounds. As usual, we will start with the first type. We'll discuss the first type, that is acyclic organic compounds. The first type, that is acyclic, or you can say open chain organic compounds. This is the first class which you have to mention, that is acyclic or open chain. It is clear from the name, these are the organic compounds which contains open chains of carbon atoms. These are the organic compounds which contains open chains of carbon atoms, which contains open chains of carbon atoms in their molecular structure. In their molecular structure. This is the definition, how we can define this very important first type, acyclic or open chain. For example, if you have propane, if this is the propane, you will find that all the three carbon atoms are present on the same straight chain. It is the open chain of carbon atoms. It is acyclic. There is no cycling. There is no ring formation. It is acyclic in nature. For example, you have the butane. You have the butane. It is also acyclic, or you can say it is the open chain organic compound. For example, if you consider this one, butene. Yeah, you can say the propene. This one is propene. Or you can say you have the butane. When we go through the nomenclature, you have to give the IPAC names of these. This is open chain. This is also open chain. This is open chain. This is also open chain. Or you can have the propyne. You can have the propyne. All the bonds are sigma bonds, single bonds, alkane. This one is alkene. Double bonds are there. One or more double bonds are there. And you have the triple bond here. It means that this open chain, this acyclic, it is of two types, three types. The first one, you can have alkanes. When all the carbon, when all the bonds are single bonds, there are no pi bonds are present in the molecular structure. When we have the pi bond, it is alkene, and when you have the triple bond, it is alkyne. You have to simply remember the first point. What is meant by acyclic? What is meant by open chain? These are the organic compounds which contains open chains of organic compounds in their molecular structure. They can be alkanes. They can be alkenes. They can be alkynes. These alkenes, you know, these are known as saturated. These are known as saturated hydrocarbons, and double bond and triple bond, these are known as unsaturated. You have to also remember this category. The first category, alkane, these are known as saturated, and the second category and third, alkene and alkyne, these are collectively known as unsaturated hydrocarbon. Hydro unsaturated means they can be either, they can either contain double or they can contain triple bond. Remember this point. We are talking about the first type, that is acyclic. It means that they contain open chains of carbon atoms. Here you have to mention, these are further two types. The first one is linear. Linear open chain. And the second, we have branched open chain. Dear students, it means that the first class, acyclic, it is of two types, that is linear. If all the carbon atoms are present on the same chain, on the same straight chain, that is linear open chain compounds. And when the straight chain contains branches, at that time it is known as branched open chain. For example, if you have the pentane, I will take the example of butane. You can take the example of butane. You will find that all the carbon atoms, they are present on the same chain, on the same single chain, straight chain. Hence, it is known as linear open chain compound. If you have isobutane, you will find that the straight chain, it contains a branch, or you can say all the carbon atoms are not present on the same chain, on the same straight chain. Here we have a branch, hence this one is known as branched open chain. You have to simply remember, acyclic, this class is of two types. The first is linear open chain, when all the carbon atoms are present on the same straight chain. We have the second type, that is branched open chain, when branches are present along the main chain. For example, if you have another example of this branched one, you can have two branches. The compound can be of this type. There can be two branches attached to the straight chain along the main chain. It is also an example of branched chain. This is the first type, acyclic, or you can say open chain. How you can define? These are the organic compounds which contains open chains of carbon atoms in their molecular structure. They can be linear, they can be branched, they can be alkanes, and they can be alkynes, or you can say they can be saturated or unsaturated. Another important point you have to mention here, acyclic organic compounds. This is a very important point you have to mention. Acyclic organic compounds are commonly known as, these are known as aliphatic compounds. This is the important point you have to mention. The first category, that is acyclic organic compounds, these are popularly known as aliphatic compounds. Why these are known as aliphatic compounds? It has been derived from the Greek word aliphatos. Aliphatos meaning fat, animal fat. Aliphatos meaning animal fat, or you can say the fat, because the earlier members of this category have been originally obtained from the animal fat. Because the earlier members of this class have been originally obtained from the animal fat, hence the name aliphatos has been given to this class. Acyclic organic compounds, these are popularly known as aliphatic compounds. The word aliphatos meaning animal fat. Why these are known as aliphatic compounds? Because the earlier members of this class have been originally obtained from the animal fat, hence these are commonly, popularly known as aliphatic compounds. Now we will consider the second type of organic compound. The first type we have discussed, that is open chain or acyclic. The second class we will start here, that is cyclic, or you can say closed chain organic compounds. Closed chain organic compound. This is the second class. Closed chain organic compounds. Dear students, it is clear from the name, cyclic, or you can say closed chain organic compounds. These are the compounds which contains closed chains, or you can say rings of carbon atoms. Closed chains are rings of carbon atoms in their molecular structure. in their molecular structure. It is opposite to the first type. In the first type, all the carbon atoms, they are acyclic, there is no ring formation. But here there is cyclization, there is ring formation. And when the carbon atoms are in the ring form, when they are in the cycle form, at that time the category, the type is known as cyclic, or it is clear from the name that it is closed chain organic compounds. Remember this point, this is the second class, cyclic or closed. How you can remember, how you can define, these are the compounds which contains closed chains of carbon atoms. In the next lecture, dear students, we will classify this second type that is cyclic or closed chain. Dear students, this type is a further, it is of two types. It is the A, I can say A part, we can say the first type, homocyclic. This class has been further classified two categories. In the next lecture, we will discuss these two types, homocyclic, or it is also known as carbocyclic compounds. And the second type I can list here, B part, that is heterocyclic compounds. This type, second class, cyclic, it is of two types, homocyclic and heterocyclic. Inshallah, in the next lecture, we will discuss in a detailed manner these two types, homocyclic, or you can say carbocyclic compounds, and the second, that is heterocyclic compounds. Till then, fi amanillah.